All right, so today we're going to talk about a property of water called specific heat. It's a weird term, and actually specific heat is a property of all tangible objects, but today we're going to go all in on water. So what is specific heat? By definition, specific heat is the amount of energy required to raise the temperature of 1 gram of a substance by 1 degree Celsius. And what does that mean, Mr. Merck? Basically, it's just a measurement of how tolerant a substance, namely water, can be to having heat applied to it. The technical jargon about 1 gram of a substance by 1 degree Celsius is just a measurement that scientists use to compare different substances to each other. The specific heat of water is 4.18, remember that. And this number is given as the unit of joules per gram of water per degree Celsius at around room temperature. So if you literally add 4.18 joules into a single gram of water, that would raise the temperature of that 1 gram by 1 degree Celsius. Here's an easy example. So let's compare water to ethanol. It's an alcoholic base substance, but let's look at the bigger picture. Specific heat is asking us how much heat or energy will it take for a substance to react or change. Well, it's kind of obvious, right? On one hand, we have water, and on the other hand, we have alcohol or ethanol. It doesn't take much for the ethanol to dry up, so you already know that it's ready to react with minimal effort. Relatively speaking, to you and me, it doesn't take any heat at all to cause ethanol to react, change, or eventually evaporate. Water, on the other hand, takes way more time, even with the help of the sun. The amount of energy required to increase the temperature of water is generally quite high, 4.18 joules high, and so its specific heat is also high. But why, Mr. Merck? Why is it so high? The answer comes from its hydrogen bonds. Yeah, there goes that word again. Think about this for a second. What happens to the molecule inside water as its temperature rises? Basically, as we add 4.18 joules, when the temperature of a substance rises, it's due to the molecules being unstable, shifting, moving, and colliding. These little molecules begin flying around, bouncing violently off each other as temperature rises. You can see a similar behavior when you boil water. Hydrogen bonds must be broken before its temperature rises, and this is why water has such a high specific heat. And only until then can the water be transferred by breaking hydrogen bonds and allowing free movement, and then can the temperature go up. By the way, specific heat is measured by joules, which is a unit of how we measure energy. Specific heat equals joules over grams over degrees Celsius. That's how many joules in each gram and all that engulfed in each degree of Celsius. Ha, wrap that around your head. One other thing I forgot to mention, but can be inferred from the video so far. The more hydrogen bonds a molecule has, the more likely it is to have a higher specific heat. Again, because it takes in a lot of heat to break apart all those hydrogen bonds in water. And also, from our previous examples, ethanol doesn't have nearly as many hydrogen bonds as water does. But let's say you have plenty of energy and you can force it into water. You've broken past the specific threshold, basically raising every last gram of water to the point that water starts to become gas. This is called heat of vaporization. It's the energy it takes to change 1 gram of water into gas. Okay, quick pause. Let's really think hard about this for a sec. Let's say you were given a single gram of water, just one, and you're standing at room temperature, 25 degrees Celsius, and that would be the temperature of the water you're holding as well. If you wanted to increase the temperature of that single gram of water to 26 degrees, you'd add the amount of specific heat of water. You would need to add 4.18 joules of energy to that 1 gram. And now its temperature is 26 degrees Celsius. Now, in order for water to turn from liquid to gas, the temperature of that gram needs to be 100 degrees Celsius. Do you see where I'm going here? If you wanted to turn this single gram of water into gas, you'd need to add the equivalent amounts of specific heat 75 times to accomplish this. You would literally need over 300 joules to vaporize a single gram of water. So unsurprisingly, water has a high heat of vaporization. You have to throw in lots of energy into water for it to turn to gas. But what does this even mean, Mr. Merg? What does it have to do with the foundation of life in biology? Well, when life was still in its molecular infancy, the idea was that water helped cool and stabilize those soon to become organic molecules, which opened a path towards building larger molecular structures of life. To put it in other words, life's chemical evolution from inorganic to organic was theorized to have been protected by this process from any damaging energy. Water acted as a shield, providing a barrier, regulating the extreme temperatures, absorbing the elements, allowing the inorganic and organic building blocks to grow unchallenged. Well, that's it for the video. Thumbs up if you liked it, subscribe if you loved it. If you have any questions about the topic or the video, please leave a comment below. Thanks for watching. See you again soon. Peace.